May kalayuan, di man tanaw, di na uubusan ng tiwala sa sarili, lakas ng dasal. Alam mong sa dulo ng bawat taon, naghihintay ang masayang panahon. Lahat ng gumbay at paghihintay, ang damdamin ay tumatawid sa lupa, sa dagat o sa langit.
Welcome to SPEECHmas! I'm so happy I finally get to see all your beautiful faces!
Same gang! I am so excited to finally be here at the culmination event of the 12 Days of SPEECHmas. I am sure that all of you are just as excited as we are. But first, let's talk about the house rules for today's SPEECHmas. Number one, listen attentively to whatever the speaker is saying. Number two, mute your mic or limit background noises when someone is talking. Number three, if you have any questions, you might either enter them on the chat box or use the raise hand option and wait until you get called. You may also address them during the open forum allotted at the end of the meeting. And number four, always remember to address people with respect.
Yes. Now, number five, if you ever want to say something, let the other person speaking finish first. Six, you are encouraged to turn on your camera throughout the session. Seven, participation is a must during activities. Number eight, you are allowed to eat during the session. And number nine, enjoy and just be yourself. This is a safe space for everyone. All right, so those are the house rules for the SPEECHmas event. For everyone who doesn't know yet, SPEECHmas is a special gift prepared by the UB Manila BS Speech Pathology freshmen that will hopefully allow all of you to get to know speech pathology better.
And maybe even consider it as a part of your future.
Yes. Now that I think about it, this event is pretty jam-packed.
That's right, because we have prepared many gifts for you. Let's start with a present of fun.
What kind of fun?
We're about to find out. Let's call some of our friends in Santa's Village, Angel and Louie, for some classic Christmas games.
Thank you, Gang and Czar. So, hello, guys. I am Angel, and I am here today with...
Hi, I'm Louie. And me and Angel are the two of the many game masters that you will meet for today.
So, Louie, nakikita ko monito-monito daw yung nasa screen. Ano yun?
Monito-monito. Do you know Bring Me, Angel?
Hindi. Ano ba yun?
Okay. It's basically the same thing, pero pinaganda lang natin.
Interesting. Bring Me, pero make it Christmassy. Ooh. So, in case you guys didn't know, or parang nalilito pa ka kayo, ito yung mechanics ng game. So, first, everyone is asked to bring objects based on the said theme. Volunteers or selected persons will be asked to explain how their chosen object would be a great Christmas present. You guys will be given 15 seconds to find your gift.
Wow, yes naman, Angel. Thank you for explaining to us what monito-monito is. So, why don't we give them a little example naman?
Gusto ko yan, Louie. Sige. Bring me something long and hard.
Sabi ko, little lang eh. Pero sige. Bring me something long and hard. Wait. Ito. I can't find anything eh. Charan!
Long ba yan?
Is this sufficient na for long?
Long? Oh, bakit naman yun pwedeng Christmas present, Lou? Ano ba yan?
This is a nail polisher. Pang maarte like me. Diba? It's pink. So cute.
Oh, ayan guys. So, feeling ko naman, alam nyo na. Alam nyo na, diba? So, bago tayo mag-start, we would like to ask everyone to open their cameras so we can see who will bring the items first. So, para meron yung onting excitement, paunahan tayo dito.
Yes.
Pero kung hindi kayo pwede mag-open ng cameras, no pressure naman.
So, guys, are you all ready na? Let's begin. So, first item, go Angel.
Ay, ako ba? Okay, so...
Drum roll. Yeah.
Okay. So, okay. Our first item is, go Louie.
Bring me something that starts with the letter S.
S, guys. Go. S. S.
Christ, my highest hymn adored. Christ, the everlasting Lord.
Ganyan pala yung ko. May kurang makita yung itsura ko. Sorry. Okay, ikaw.
Okay. So, yung nakita kong hindi natin blockmate, like, thank you blockmates for participating. So, yung nakita kong hindi natin blockmate na nagdala ng gamit, I see Felix. Felix ba yun? Felix Miguel Bartolome.
Hi, so, Felix.
Pwede mo po bang i-share kung ano yung something that starts with an S at bakit siya magandang Christmas gift?
Can you hear me ba?
Hello?
Can you hear me? So,
yes.
Ito pong hawak ko is a stick. Magandang gift to sa bayaw ko kasi Makulit po yung anak niya. So, pwedeng pamalo.
Parang tumatawa, Maria.
Sana never niyang magamit.
Never sana talaga.
Never magamit. Okay, so I think we can proceed na to our next item. So what is our next item?
Oh.
It is, bring me something that is green. Oh, go guys, green. Okay, Lou, nandito ka pa ba?
Oo, nandito pa ako.
So, pwede ka ba pumili ng ating winner for this round?
Patingin nga. Dapat ba hindi natin kaklase?
Ako.
Pag na si Ria.
Oo.
Patingin ang mga green things nyo. Wala akong
makikita. Si Diana.
Gusto ko yung ano. Ito ko yung pinakita ni Baba.
Baba, ano ba pinakita mo, Baba?
Tingnan natin. Sobra effort tong kay Baba.
Tapos pinatay. Green na screen.
Ang galing! Palakpakan!
Palakpakan natin.
So, Baba, paki-explain bakit siya magandang Christmas gift, yung green screen?
Oh, ka.
Okay.
Para magamit yung background. Ganyan. Ganyan.
Malaki pa ulo mo. Okay, Ino. What is our next item?
Okay, for our next item, bring me something that you put in your mouth. Go, guys!
Aga, oh, hindi ko natawag dito.
Kaya yung bawang mo. Pag-insert ko lang yung bawang. Okay, guys. Something you put in your mouth. Huwag na kayo mahiya. Ayan. So, what is... patingin niya po ulit. Ano yung mga something that you put in your mouth. Ayan. Yung may pagkain. Hello, Maria Tricia. Ria, tsaka ka na. Hello, Maria Tricia. Pwede mo bang i-share kung ano yung item mo?
Hi, Nova po.
Nova?
Hi.
Bakit siya maganda this gift?
Pang for people na ano, mahilig sa junk foods.
Ayan, si Ria. Kilala mo ba si Ria? Hanapin mo siya dito.
Hi.
Hi, Ria. Nag-cheesy siya.
Ito yung sa akin.
Cheesy.
Okay, thank you for that wonderful gift. So what is our next item? Bring me something that makes a sound. Something that makes a sound. Okay, so Louie, sino pwede dito, Louie?
Tingnan niya ng mga kinuha niyo that makes a sound. Yung iba ba walang dala kasi sila na yon. Sila na yun that makes a sound.
Sino, Louie? Sino ang ating winner for this round?
Who is this? Trixie Lou de Guzman. Hi.
Hi, Trixie.
Hi, Trixie.
Hi, can you hear me?
Yes.
Hi. Hi. So this is a piggy bank. It was in my room, so I thought it was funny because it makes sound.
Pag binigay mo yan, may laman na?
No, no.
Okay, okay. Thank you. Have fun.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you for that gift. Sana matanggap ko siya someday. So, what is our next item?
So, for our next item. Last item na ba to, Angel?
Yes, last item na.
Okay, bring us something that reminds you of Christmas.
Baka may magdadala dyan ng Christmas tree. Ayos ka.
Hello.
Turn ako ito. Plastic no Shopee.
Okay. So, sino ba? Pagkini niya po ng something that reminds you of Christmas. Pia, thank you po dun sa ano mo, pack ng Shopee. Ay, plastic lang pala. Wala na yung laman.
Meron si Felix.
Si Felix?
Ang dami niyang dala. Oh, sige. Spotlight ulit natin siya.
Go
wow.
Plastic.
Wow. Wow.
At you. Felix. Ano yan? Ano yan? Something that reminds you of Christmas?
Groceries. Sigurado ako. Kasi every Christmas talaga, like, isang puntahan niya lang sa grocery, tapos, like, ano, sobra pa sa 10 bags yung dala niyo. Sa sobrang dami niyong pinamili. Sa sobrang dami nitong dala ko, marirement yung Christmas.
Tama, madaming pagkain dapat pag Pasko.
Tama. Gusto niya ba? Pwede ko patala.
Yeah, sige.
Ako!
Okay, guys. So, thank you for participating in our icebreaker.
Yes, and don't worry. We will still have more games prepared for all of you later.
Now that we have broken the ice, Ginganzar, the floor is yours. Thank you.
Thank you. Yay! That was fun, right? We hope that you enjoyed our very first present. Now, to officially start this event, there's a special someone who would like to talk to all of you.
That's right. She is Ms. Suseline E. Pascual. Ms. Pascual is currently the president of the Philippine Association of Speech Language Pathologists. She is a graduate of both BS Speech Pathology and Master in Rehabilitation Science Speech Pathology from the College of Allied Medical Professions, or CAMP, in the University of the Philippines, Manila. Ms. Susie has dedicated her career not only to serve those in need, but also to further improve and uphold the SP profession in the country. She also served as the Vice President and Treasurer of the Philippine Association of Speech Pathologists from 2014 to 2017. When not seeing clients, Ms. Susie teaches both undergraduate and graduate students in CAMP at UPM, supervises interns at Core Skills Therapy Center, where she is a partner and gives regular early intervention seminars to parents of Down Syndrome Association of the Philippines Incorporated. Ms. Susie has received her training for prompts for restructuring oral muscular phonetic targets and for MNRI dynamic and postural reflex pattern integration, MNRI oral facial reflex integration 1 and 2, and MNRI tactile integration, and Hanan Center's More Than Words, It Takes Two to Talk and Talkability Parent Training Programs. Let's have Ma'am Susie Pascual for her opening remarks.
Hey, good afternoon. All right. First, I would like to thank you for considering the Philippine Association of Speech Language Pathologists as one of your partners in this endeavor. I'm hoping that you are all in good health during this meaningful holiday season and that all of you are making joyful memories with your families and loved ones. When you invited me to speak, and I was informed of your 12 days of, you know, 12 days of Christmas, the first day of Christmas. I thought I wanted to sing. Anyway, what immediately came to mind were the three wise men of the Nativity and their North Star. The three magi and that star have had different biblical, historical,
mythical, and even commercial iterations and interpretations. Historians and fact checkers are not even sure if there are three of them and if there is even a star. But what's verified as truth is that a group of highly dedicated people during a significant period in history of extreme hardship, uncertainty, and change were persistent with their search and were guided by a goal to offer their gifts of celebration and thanks to the Messiah. We are going through a pandemic. There, I said it again. And you may have heard it several times, almost every day. Or it's not even almost, it's really every day, right? And it's a bummer to keep on stating the obvious when we should be celebrating your Christmas get-together or this culminating activity. And everyone has had almost a full year of difficulties and losses. It must be the suckiest to be students who are supposed to be enjoying your first years in university and having the fun, enriching, and connected college experience that everyone before you has had. Yes, it's not fair. It is not fair. However, compared to every other student of speech-language pathology that has come before you, you are special. Because you are doing and achieving things we have never done before and we have never even thought possible before. Your teachers and professors have done and are doing work, their work, as it has never been done before or even thought possible before. And you are learning things we are only just grappling with now. It's not easy. Things that will permanently change and greatly improve our profession and our ways of service. So I would say that all of you are the Magi. Each one of you has been dedicated during this significant period in history, okay? Dedicated in your persistence, in your search for learning, for purpose, and meaning in your life. You are guided by your stars. Your stars here are your loving family, your hardworking teachers and professors, and of course, your promising goals. And you bring gifts that are of immense value. So we thank you for your offerings of hard work, stubborn persistence, admirable resilience, and youthful hope, as was shown with this endeavor. I really hope you hang on to it. And with that, I say Merry Christmas to everyone, and may we all have a truly blessed new year. Thank you again for including PASP in this endeavor. Have a good day.
Thank you very much, Ma'am Pascual, for those uplifting words. Now, for the next portion of this program, we will have three short sessions complete with lectures and games all about speech pathology. Make sure to do your best in the games because we will be having another raffle at the end of this event where the members of the winning groups will be given a chance to win one of three prizes.
I'm sure some of you will already know this because we'll be talking about the information discussed in the pit stops, although this will be a compressed version.
Yep, so make sure to watch the actual pit stops for the full picture. And if you have any questions, feel free to type them down in the chats at any point in the event. We will get to it as soon as we can. Now, for our first lecture, we have one of our blockmates presenting all about speech pathology. Let's all welcome Faith.
Hi, guys. I'm Faith, and today I will be providing you all the introductory information that you need to know about the career. topic is all about speech pathology. For the objectives, first, we will introduce speech pathology and speech pathologists, discuss different career opportunities, and determine the importance of the course. We will discuss the definition of speech pathology, but next, please. Thank you. We will discuss the definition of speech pathology, who speech pathologists are, what they do, the common misconceptions people have about them, and their ultimate goal. Afterwards, dun naman tayo sa roles nila in health-oriented institutions, school-oriented institutions, speech pathology as a pre-med course, and speech pathology as a career on its own. Una sa lahat, ano nga ba ang speech pathology? According to Ferdelisa Danda S. Garcia, a medical doctor, a certified speech pathologist, and the member of the Philippine Association of Speech Pathologists, speech pathology is a profession devoted to serving people with communication disorders and those who have difficulty in swallowing. It is an allied health profession devoted to the evaluation, diagnosis, management, and prevention of human communication and swallowing disorders. With this being said, who are speech pathologists and what do they do? According to the American Speech, Language, and Hearing Association, speech pathologists prevent, assess, diagnose, and treat patients from womb to tomb with speech sounds, language, social communication, voice, fluency, and feeding and swallowing disorders. Please take note that from womb to tomb means that their clients include anyone from infants to senior citizens with insufficient and delayed speech, articulation, or voice disorders, hearing impairments, and those who experience stroke and traumatic events that caused brain damage. Speech pathologists usually work in health-oriented and/or education-oriented institutions. This will be discussed later, pero bago yon, let's discuss the common misconceptions people have about SPs. When people hear about speech pathology, tapos hindi sila familiar kung ano yun, they may assume that the course is similar to BA Mass Communication and that speech pathologists are good at communication kasi merong speech dun sa title nila. But during college and postgraduate studies, SPs would try to understand the speech and language processes as well as the mechanisms tsaka kung paano sila nagpa-function. People with problems in functioning will then be helped. Yung last naman na isa pang common misconception is a speech pathologist's ultimate goal. While it is true that speech pathologists treat patients with communication disorders kasi nga meron silang difficulties sa understanding, hearing, talking, swallowing, or meron namang problema dun sa structures na involved sa processes na yun, hindi lang naman yun yung ginagawa nila. What do I mean by this? Next slide, please. What is the ultimate goal of a speech pathologist? According to Jeremiah Penga, another certified speech pathologist and the member of PASP, the end goal of a speech pathologist is to improve the quality of life of a person. Improve how? I'm going to give you two examples. First is a toddler. Tawagin natin siyang Ken Adam. He has visual acuity and cerebral palsy. Dahil sa cerebral palsy niya, limited lang yung oral communication skills niya. Before siyang umattend ng speech therapy, he isn't capable of producing any sound. But through therapy, he can now produce one-syllable sounds. Halos, most of the time, vowel yung nagagawa niya, and halos laging end ng lines or last syllable ng words yung napoproduce niya. So by definition, kasama siya sa clients ng speech pathologist. But there's also a 17-year-old. Ang pangalan naman natin sa kanya is Regina Falange. She has high-functioning ADHD. Wala siya sa definition ng kasama sa clients ng speech pathologists kasi wala siyang delayed speech, wala siyang difficulties, wala siyang problema sa structures. Pero for a 17-year-old, she doesn't know how to get to know a person. I actually met her a couple of months ago, tapos sabi ng therapist niya, "This is Faith. She goes to UPM and she studies speech pathology. You should ask her 5 questions to get to know her." Tapos syempre, diba, when getting to know someone, you would ask them their names, their age, their likes and dislikes, and their hobbies. Pero since nasabi nga sa kanya before na I study sa UPM, medyo dun siya nag-focus dun sa UPM tsaka dun sa course ko. Another thing is that for a 17-year-old, hindi siya masyadong sure kung paano nag-work yung mga bagay sa grocery. Like, she knows na kailangan mo kumuha ng cart. But before the therapy session, hindi niya alam na may separate aisles for different things. Tapos kapag nagbabayad ka, diba, dapat yung mga frozen things mo or yung mga malalamig dapat ilalagay mo sa tray para hindi magkalat yung water kapag nagme-melt sila. Tapos, when paying din, tapos ipapack na yung mga things, provided siya ng options kung saan niya ilalagay. Like, she could put it in a paper bag, in a plastic bag, or a recyclable bag. Hindi niya alam na bawal maglagay ng masyadong mabibigat na bagay sa paper bags. Kasi diba, kapag linagay mo doon, mabubutas yung paper bag. Tapos, yung sagot niya naman sa recyclable bags is, nauna niyang linagay yung mamon. Pero diba, if you put something heavier on top of it, magsisquish siya. This means na she doesn't attend speech therapy because she has communication disorders, but she goes to speech therapy because her life skills are not appropriate for her age. So, sila ng therapist nila, they're using speech therapy as an avenue para magsabay yung level ng age niya, pati yung skills niya. Now, let's move on to the career opportunities of a speech pathologist. In health or... Okay. Speech pathologists that are health facility-based work with medical teams, such as doctors and nurses, where they get referrals and treat patients afterwards. They often get referrals for cases such as stroke, post-surgery complications in adults, and referrals for early intervention of school-aged children because they're born with disorders or those who have gone through traumatic experiences that predisposes them to speech and language delay. After nila makakuha ng referral, syempre, they're going to evaluate the patient before choosing an appropriate approach kung paano nila sila i-treat. They are often found in private practices such as clinics. Maraming clinics sa Pilipinas na nag-offer ng free services for their clients. Hindi siya all year round, pero yung iba nagbibigay sila ng 2 weeks or 1 month per year na free yung therapy na in-offer nila kasi hindi naman lahat kayang mag-afford ng therapy. They're also found in physicians' offices and hospitals. Next naman ay yung speech pathologists in school-based institutions. They are often found in schools, yung elementaries and high schools, and colleges and universities. So colleges and universities, they can work as instructors and or participate in conducting researches regarding various disorders and therapy methods. Lastly, yung community-based yung community-based therapists. Dr. Fridelisa Garcia is a speech therapist na nag-work sa community. Tapos, ang sabi niya sa amin is, as a community-based rehabilitation therapist, it has been my primary advocacy to have more rehabilitation professionals, such as speech pathologists working with individuals with disabilities and their families in communities and promoting inclusion, participation, and developing themselves to gain their own voice. Community-based therapists usually diagnose, provide consultation, and participate in the lawmaking process for people with disabilities. Most people na nag-work sa community ay volunteers. Next slide, please. Doon naman tayo sa speech pathology as a pre-med course. If you want to pursue medicine in the future, here's why you should consider speech pathology as your pre-med. Anatomical and physiological backgrounds with cases that you encounter as a speech pathologist as a speech pathologist, our advantages if you want to pursue the subspecialties of developmental pediatrics or otorhinolaryngology. Based on what we've learned so far this first semester, nakakatulong siya sa developmental pediatrics because kasama sa aaralin mo as a speech pathologist is yung lifespan development ng isang tao. Next slide, please. Kumusta naman ba ang pagpapractice ng SP while also practicing medicine? According to Dr. Garcia ulit, as a speech pathologist and medical doctor working in a community-based setting, I am able to use both the skills and knowledge I gained from these two professions to better serve and contribute towards the development of communities. Fun fact about Dr. Garcia is pagkatapos niyang mag-take ng med, and nung nag-start siyang mag-practice ng medicine, nag-stop muna siya sa pagiging speech pathologist niya. But after a few years, bumalik siya. So, what I want you guys to take away from this is, if you ever want to pursue speech pathology, tas mag-med kayo after, please don't forget your role as a speech pathologist kahit na meron na kayong role as a doctor. Last but not the least, bakit nga ba kailangan ng speech pathology? Bakit hindi lang ba siya isang pre-med course? Well, as speech pathology is easily overlooked, yet very essential because there are a lot of children born with deficiencies and developmental delays. There is a big demand in rehabilitation professionals catering to individuals with speech-language disorders. Take note that a lot of SP graduates are situated in Luzon. This will be discussed later sa SP situation. So, ang dami-dami ating region, kapag naging SP kayo, pwede kayong pumunta sa iba pang regions and treat patients there. Wait lang, not yet done. Not yet done. Okay. So, I know a lot of people who want to pursue med para makatulong. But let's not forget that SPs do the same thing. Sobrang significant ng impact nila sa development ng bata, and based on prior experience, kapag meron kang client with a really challenging case, tapos ang tagal nyo na nag-work together, tapos wala pa rin siyang, wala pa rin breakthrough. Kapag nagkaroon na ng progress, it's super fulfilling, tapos mawawala lahat ng pagod mo, tapos ang super rewarding niya lang talaga. Yan lang. So let's have a quick recall. First, speech pathologists prevent, assess, diagnose, and treat patients with speech, language, communication, voice, fluency, and feeding and swallowing disorders. They work in health-related, education-oriented, and community-based setting. The importance of speech pathology has something to do with their ultimate goal, which is that they work to improve the quality of life of a person. Here is a run-through of my reference. Yeah. Ayun yung reference natin. I hope you learned something from my lecture and stay tuned for the rest. Thank you!
Thank you so much, Faith. It's still so interesting no matter how many times I hear it. Right, Zar? Zareen, naka-mute ka, girl.
Sorry. Okay, but just a disclaimer, all names and cases are purely fictional to set the example for the professional background of a speech pathologist. But yes, Ging, I totally agree. Speech pathology and actually speech in general is very interesting to study. That's why we have prepared a fun game that will hopefully make you think the same.
That's right. Before we welcome the Game Masters for Maligayang Christmas and Merry Pasko, all of you will be divided into groups and admitted to different breakout rooms.
The groups that we have today are Kutitaps, Stars ng Pasko, Silent Nights, Bebengkas.
Noel et al's, Fabulous, Little Drama Squad, and finally, The Wise Men.
All right, see you in a bit.
some kitty cars too. Oh, Santa Claus is coming to town. Whoa, yeah. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town. One more time now. Santa Claus is coming to town. Whoa, yeah. Santa Claus is coming to town.
Perfect Christmas is to spend it with you.
May people na wala pang assignment. Si Angel Leukemia. Yes, ako check na lang.
Yes, wait lang. Okay, wait lang. Saan group ba siya dapat?
Angel.
Pwede nyo rin i-chat kung alam nyo anong group nyo and ma-assign.
VI, hindi ko siya malagay sa ano. Ikaw lang yata.
Sabihin mo na lang, ako na lang.
Group 5, si Angel Lafini.
Si...
Si Tio. Wait lang.
Last name yun.
Wait, wala. Bang. Si Hidalgo, group 8.
Junio, tsaka lakad. Ayun, kita ko yung stars na first one. Wala bang search features? Control F. Ayun.
Star ng Pasko si Junio.
Question during
si Junio.
Walang ano siya.
Okay. Hindi pa yun na. Wala, wala. Walang question.
Hi, girl. You can go to your breakout room.
You can join now. Wala, puro lang, ano, tayo yung nag-chat. Iwan. Mayroon pang... Pwede na kayo mag-join sa breakout room. Meron?
Lana. Yay! They're all okay now.
Yay! Okay.
Oh, join.
May kailangan ka pa ba?
Shot na lang ako if ever.
Sige, sige. Join na lang sa 2 muna. Bye! Bye. Nagsiyawit ang mga anghel.
Alright, so we're just waiting for Stars ng Pasko and Fabulous para for their scores to know who is the winner of the first game. Right now, leading is the Wise Men with 14 points. Game Masters of Fabulous, send in your scores.
It's the most beautiful time of the year. Lights fill the streets, spreading so much cheer. I should be playing in the winter snow. I'ma be under the mistletoe. I don't wanna miss out on the holiday, but I can't stop staring at your face. I should be playing
okay.
In the winter snow.
So
I'ma be under the mistletoe.
Even I got confused to that in the game. I hope you all had fun. A big congratulations to the group that won. Wise nga naman, the Wise Men. If you feel a bit tired, don't worry because we have another message to uplift your spirits.
Yes, a special someone has prepared a message to inspire all of you beautiful children. And that is Sir Fernando Alejandro C. Ligon. He is currently the chair of the Board of Trustees in the Philippine Association of Speech Pathologists and an associate professor in the Department of Speech Pathology at the College of Allied Medical Professions in the University of the Philippines, Manila. He is also a speech pathology consultant in the Manila Cleft Care Center, Operation Smile Philippines, and Cleft Rehabilitation Program of the Hope Volunteers Foundation, Incorporated. He attained a bachelor's degree in speech pathology and a master's in health profession education in the University of the Philippines, Manila. Currently, he is a PhD candidate in the University of the Philippines, Diliman, for educational administration. He has received awards for Outstanding Faculty and Extension Service in the University of the Philippines, Manila in 2006, Outstanding Volunteer Award in the Operation Smile Philippines in 2013, and Outstanding Service Award in the Philippine Association of Speech Pathologists in 2016. Without further ado, let us all watch a message from Sir Ligot.
Hello everyone. Now that you've heard everything about speech pathology, you're probably asking yourself, is this the one for me? Is this the college course that I want to spend the next 4 years of my life in? Or is this the profession that I want to build my career on? Just like you had the same questions years ago, and I knew that the answer was not going to be an easy one. So let me tell you a short story. Some years ago, there was this high school student who was about to enter college. Coming from a family of doctors, he was naturally drawn to the medical profession. He was destined to join the ranks of healers in the medical field, or so he thought. As a student, he knew that there were so many professional fields out there that he could be part of, but he only had one thing in mind, and that was to become a doctor. To be of help to someone, to help heal someone's physical affliction, or to help change the life of another person. So in college, he enrolled in speech pathology, thinking that it would be his pre-med course. It belonging to the science field. He knew that it was going to be his stepping stone towards medicine, his ticket to med school, or so he thought. Now, midway through his internship, in one of the preschools he was doing his practicum in, a teacher asked him what his plans were after college, and he said, without hesitation, med school, of course. Now, the teacher said in a saddened tone, I hope you give speech therapy or speech pathology a chance, because there are so many male students out there who needed the help of a male speech therapist. They needed somebody whom they can relate to, because at that time, speech pathology was mostly occupied by female speech therapists. Back then, the conversation didn't mean much to the student. But one word echoed in the student's mind so loudly, and that was the word help. He remembered why he wanted to become a doctor, and that was to be of help to someone. He then realized that he could be of help to someone, even if he was not a doctor. He realized that there were other people, children, with other conditions that needed healing or helping. After 3 semesters of internship, spending each day of the week with children with communication problems, adults who could not speak because of a stroke, children whose speech was affected by a facial deformity, he then realized that these individuals needed help as well. He then decided to give speech pathology a chance. He decided to be of help to these individuals, gain or regain their ability to communicate better, and help make their lives better. Friends, this student stands before you today, inviting you to be part of this profession, a profession that seeks to help others develop a better way of communicating, a profession that helps make others become functional members of society, a profession that helps change people's lives for the better. I hope that you give speech pathology a chance. If helping is what you want to do, if to make the life of others better, then probably speech pathology is the one for you. Thank you for listening and have a good day. Hello everyone. Now that you've heard everything.
What a beautiful message. Thank you so much to Sir Ligot. It really makes you think about what life could be like as a speech pathologist. Well, you can think about that during our 2-minute break happening right now.
Be back soon!
During this break, we would like to thank Santa's special helpers that made all of this possible. This SPEECHmas is in association with the Philippine Association of Speech Pathologists, co-presented by the UP Collegiate Association of Speech Pathologists, with our major sponsors, the Arum Shop, PH, Blank Slate, Taco Kombucha, and Succeed. Our minor sponsors, Fan Shack, Mooncake Moonlight, and the UP Sigma Alpha Nu Sorority. I'm gonna hold you close. Make sure that you Are y'all back? Welcome back, if you are. I hope you thought about the speech pathologist's life during that break. Sorry, nakamute ka ulit.
But if you haven't thought about it, don't worry because our next lecture is the SP Situationer where we can find out how the field is. One of our blockmates, again, will be discussing this topic. Ten, the stage is yours.
Hi, everyone. So I'm Athena, or you can call me Ten. So the lecture for today is entitled Speech Pathology Situationer. Before we go into the lecture proper, let me introduce that we have for today first. So first is to briefly discuss the history of SP in the Philippines, to situate SP in the Philippines through the Filipino SLP survey, to differentiate SP in the national and global scene, to determine the effects of the pandemic on the profession, and lastly, to ponder on what we can do as possible future SPs. So next slide, please. So before we, let me show you an overview first. So we will be talking about the past, present, and lastly, the future of speech pathology in the Philippines. So for the past, I will be introducing to you the brief history of speech pathology. Then for the present, I will be discussing some key findings from the 2019 SLP survey. And we will also be comparing the national and global scene of speech pathology. And I will be introducing to you how SP has been affected by the pandemic. And of course, lastly, speech pathology in the future. So for the brief history of speech pathology, started in the Genesis years. So the Genesis years are focused on how speech pathology as a program was developed and how it started in the Philippines. So it first began as a way to make education accessible for the deaf here in the Philippines, which was brought about by the Americans. Then speech pathology was then proposed by Dr. Francisco Nemenzo as a program in the Department of Speech and Drama in the University of the Philippines in Diliman. And significant people like Dr. Guillermo Damian and Professor Rosella Sutta-Disastro made significant contributions and efforts to make the genesis of speech pathology in the country possible. So next slide, please. Then we have the chances and challenges years of speech pathology. So of course, there were students who had to go through the first few years of speech pathology while it was newly implemented. So it was first implemented City of the Philippines in Manila in 1978. So the development was very unstable, but thanks to a core group of Filipino speech pathologists who helped and worked hard, they made the development of SP very stable. And with that, moving on to the growing years of speech pathology. So in these growing years, after speech pathology as a program was approved in the University of the Philippines in Diliman, three more universities offered speech pathology, and those universities will be discussed in the next lecture after mine. So each year, more and more SLPs graduate from these universities, with around 150 to 200 new therapists per year. However, with that number, masasabi pa rin talagang kulang nga talaga ang mga speech with the 2019 Filipino SLP survey. Next slide, please. So the 2019 Filipino SLP survey was an online survey conducted by the Philippine Association of Speech Pathologists with an objective to guide PASP in planning its programs. So here are some key findings. For the demographics, there were 277 respondents, 91% of which were from the Philippines or working in the Philippines, and 9% were Filipino speech pathologists who were working abroad. So the numbers look good, right? So hindi masyadong marami pa yung speech pathologists abroad. Pero meron pa rin na nang doon. So let's take a look at why later. So majority of the current practitioners are situated in NCR or in Luzon. And following NCR is Region 4A and then Region 3. So if you look at the slide here, makikita talagang unequal pa ang distribution ng speech pathologists in the Philippines. So wala masyado sa Visayas and sa Mindanao. So next slide, please. meron ring mga regions na hindi nga talaga na-reach, and an example of that is ARMM. So it can be found in the slide right there. So next slide, please. So let me present to you the ratio of speech pathologists to patients in the Philippines. So in the Philippines, it's 1:14,286. So if you think about that number, parang okay, wala lang. Pero let's compare it to the ratio that the US has. So the US has a ratio of 1:260. So I don't think I have to further explain kasi nga mas malaki naman talaga ang gap sa Philippines. So kulang nga talaga ang SPs. So with that, the demand for SLPs in the Philippines remains high. So some go abroad, as aforementioned, some pursue medicine, and some are undecided. Next slide, please. However, there are personal reasons naman on why they decide to do that with their lives or with their profession. So some factors include the better pay or salary that is offered abroad, the better quality of life abroad, and the better education and training that they can receive abroad. So this can be attributed to the work profile and the work practice issues in the country. So let's take a look at it in a comparative view in the national and the global scene of speech pathology. So the practice of speech pathology is different in every country. So next slide, please. So the differences in the work profile include the pay and standard of living, how the course program is taught to the students, and of course the practice of the profession. So it's different in countries wherein speech pathology is considered a highly developed discipline, like in the United States and Canada, also in Australia. So for example, in Australia, there are since they have very good funding for healthcare, unlike here in the country, Australia has SP clinics in every block. So it's different here in the Philippines since not a lot of SPs are distributed in the country. Most are situated in Luzon, and the patients sometimes feel very frustrated because of very long waiting lists brought about by the lack of SPs. So I'm not saying this to scare you. I am saying this so that you, as possible future speech pathologists, can also help in the future. But before we go into how you can help in the future, let's take a look at how the pandemic has affected speech pathology as a profession. So the biggest effect that the pandemic brought about to the profession was the shifting to teletherapy. So if you aren't aware of what teletherapy is basically therapy, but online. So this shift has brought about a lot of pros and cons. So, di ba nga sabi ko kanina, a lot of the SPs are situated in Luzon and mostly are nasa NCR. And most of them, if not great, they have good internet connection. Pero we have to take note of the SPs that are also found in the provinces like in Visayas and Mindanao. And they have very poor internet access. So that also becomes a barrier to effective teletherapy. So the assessment component becomes very difficult compared to when you're dealing with patients face-to-face. So however, despite these cons, there are also benefits that this shifting has brought about to the profession. So since teletherapy is done at home, there is increase of engagement of parents and or guardians in specific therapeutic sessions. And because there is increase in engagement, the parents or guardians learn more on how to support the patients. So that becomes a very good thing for the patients and the families as well. So moving on, next please. So I've discussed to you how speech pathology has evolved, its past and its present, and its differences from the national and global scene and how the pandemic has affected it. So you might be asking, why is this important to me? Like, bakit ako nandito sa Zoom meeting ngayon? Ba't ako nakikinig dito? So let me tell you, to understand how SP has evolved in the past years, to understand the past and its present situation is a great step towards what we can do for the country as possible future speech pathologists. So this leads us to the last portion of our lecture, which is speech pathology in the future. So what can you do as a future SP? So first, and foremost is, of course, to serve the underserved. So sabi ko nga kanina, may unequal distribution ng SP sa Pilipinas. So, you know, you might want to be an SP in the future. So pwede mong ma-equalize yung distribution na yan. And then we have people for research as well. So as I've been mentioning since kanina, SP has evolved a lot and it has changed from an proposed program pa lang to a profession na ngayon in the Philippines. But it doesn't have to stop where we are right now. So you can help with that in the future through research if you're into that kind of thing. So meron pang mga solutions na kailangan natin i-solve during this time. Like, there are still issues in the key frameworks of the profession and in how the program is actually handled by the universities. So, for example, there is still the lack of a standardized evaluation test for those who speak Tagalog or Filipino only, because most of the standardized evaluation tests are in English. And, you know, you might be the one who will help standardize a test for the Philippines in the future. And of course, last is to help the general public appreciate the value of community. So next slide, please. Dr. Marzan's words. Communication is beautiful. Communication makes life meaningful. It's something we don't think about often, but it's something that helps us so much. So people usually take the ability to communicate for granted. So they don't appreciate it and notice its value. Less ability is taken away from them. So imagine not being able to communicate for a day. That might be so frustrating for your part, right? Think about the other people who can't communicate their whole lives. So how frustrating would that be? So communication, we should understand that communication is a pathway to enjoy a better quality of life, because you will be able to express yourself and you will be able to interact with a lot of people through communication. So that's it for our second lecture in this culminating activity. I hope you learned a lot, and I hope you got even just a little bit inspired. So thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Ten. I hope you're also raring to go, because next we have another game for you.
The next game is called Tongue Twister. All of you will once again be divided into breakout rooms. See you in a little while.
V, are you there?
Okay na. Okay na. Wait lang, wala ka. Wala, kulang kasi kami na isa. Okay. Balik na ako.
Ano, hindi ko narinig.
the second game together with the winner ng third game. Okay. Kinakaya pa ba?
Wait lang. Na, may mga bumabalik pa, girl.
Okay, so welcome back. I hope all of you are here now. That was definitely twisty. I'm actually a little tired from that.
Well, then I guess it's a good thing that we will now be having a short break from the activities to listen to a short but definitely sweet message from someone I think you all know very, very well. She is a leader of the nation that has led us all in these trying times through not only her consistent and eloquent communication with the people, but also through providing and organizing support to all parts of the country. She is a leader that embodies the principle of all that we hope to achieve. We would like to present a recorded message from the 14th Vice President of the Republic of the Philippines, VP Maria Leonor Lenny G. Robredo.
Everyone, and congratulations to the team of first year BS Speech Pathology students from UP Manila for creating Speech Path PH. I'd also like to greet all of the high school participants in your 12 days of SPEECHmas culminating activity. I hope you are all safe and well. As practitioners, you help people who struggle with a variety of conditions, from physical trauma and strokes to COVID-19, regain the ability to communicate. This is more than just the capacity to talk. By healing their speech, you open a pathway for them to enjoy a better quality of life, the facility to express themselves, and interact more meaningfully with those around them. Rest assured that in this task, the task of ensuring that those in the margins are never left behind, that our people feel bound to each other and are part of a greater whole, hindi kayo nag-iisa. There are so many of our fellow Filipinos who share our values and who are willing to give of themselves in the spirit of bayanihan. Kaya tuloy lang tayo, sige lang, continue your pursuit of your dreams. Kasama ito sa pakikiambag ng napakaraming Pilipino tungo sa isang mas makatao, mas mapagmalasakit, at mas patas na lipunan. Maraming salamat for your efforts at mabuhay kayong lahat.
Wow, that was a very beautiful message. I hope that our Vice President's words have uplifted you all. If you need time to process all that, or maybe to stretch or drink some water, now is the time because we will be having another 2-minute break.
Please be back very soon. For now, we would like to thank Santa's special helpers that made all of this possible. The SPEECHmas is in association with Philippine Association of Speech Pathologists, co-presented by UP Collegiate Association of Speech Pathologists. Our major sponsors, Arum Shop PH, Blank Slate, Kaya Kombucha, and Succeed. Our minor sponsors, Fanshack, Mooncake Moonlight, and the UP Sigma Alpha New Sorority.
And the baby, flip a table under the tree. For me, I've been an awful girl. And the baby, the hurry down the chimney tonight.
Yes, Santa, we are still in the SPEECHmas event. It's really fun here.
Yeah. Oh, tell him not to worry because we'll head straight to the North Pole after this event.
Oh, right. Don't worry, Santa. We'll report in as soon as we finish the event. Oh, hey, everyone. Welcome back. I hope you're rested because we're going straight into Lecture 3.
Since now you know a little bit about the profession, I hope a lot of you are wondering how to get into it. Don't worry, because now we have another wonderful blockmate of ours, Sophia for SP Education.
Hi everyone! Thank you, Ging and Czar. My name is Sophia, and right now, we will be discussing the Speech Pathology Education, Lecture 3. So, from our two previous lectures, you were briefed on what speech pathology is as a profession and how a speech pathologist, or should I say how you, will be situated in the profession in the future. Now, if you were convinced enough to take on the speech path, probably your next question is, where do I start? And where do I study to become an SP? So hopefully at the end of my lecture, I can answer that question and deliver these objectives to you. Currently, there are 4 universities in the Philippines offering the BS Speech Pathology. We have the University of the Philippines, Manila, the De La Salle Medical and Health Sciences Institute, Cebu Doctors University, and University of Santo Tomas. UP Manila was the first in the country to introduce speech pathology as an undergraduate program back in 1978 to address the growing needs of Filipinos with communication difficulties. Thus, for more than 30 years, UPM was the sole university to offer the program. Not long after, CDU had also introduced the program in 2012, sorry, UST introduced the program in 2009, CDU in 2012, and DLSM HSI in 2014. Now, cutting short on these histories, let's now run through the details of the speech pathology program each university offers. So we have asked the BSSLP program chairpersons in the 4 universities to briefly discuss their speech pathology program. And this was their common ground of their responses. Let me read it to you. The BS speech language pathology is a 4-year course equipping students of appropriate knowledge and globally competent skills for their service to the Filipino people through various exposures in research and clinical services. Ano daw? Well, basically, in the next slide, we have the summary. The 4 universities envision their students to learn, apply, and serve as a professional speech language pathologist. Now, we have here a table sa baba ng slide. You might ask me, Ate Sophia, eh, pare-pare lang pala yan. Ayan, no, puro may 4, lahat may yes. So, anong pinagkaiba ng mga universities na yan? Parang mas nalito pa ako, ate. Pero, oo, syempre, kung kami rin naman ang binigyan ng ganyang information, malilito rin kami. Kaya naman, pagkatapos namin tanongin yung mga program chairpersons ng, Ma'am, sir, what's in your program? Sinunod namin ang, Ma'am, sir, what sets your program apart? But disclaimer, this lecture, I do not aim that in this lecture to belittle or like rank universities. What I just want is to help you narrow down your choices, depending on sa unique offers na binibigay ng bawat university. So let's start with UP Manila. UP is mandated to be the national university in the Philippines under the Republic Act number 9500 or what they call the UP Charter of 2008. So by law, The BSSP program of UPM is guided by the commitment of the university as a system to honor, excellence, and public service. So kaming mga squad iskarin ay exposed to local and international settings for clinical services and or research development. Then another differentiating factor of UPM is the recent revision of the BSSP program in 2018. Because of this revision, the previous curriculum was strengthened and allowing more exposure to health promotion and disability prevention, research, ICT, leadership management, and entrepreneurship for their students. Also, to complement yung mga classroom discussions, UP Manila also has the UP Camp CBR, the community-based rehabilitation, and the college-based clinic for therapy services for actual participatory activities. And to end, for UP, let me read it to you. With the UP being UP, its students are guided to become globally competent professionals to be of public service to the Filipino people with honor and excellence. This is the University of the Philippines, Manila. This is the hashtag TatakUP. Will you come and be part of it? Hey. Okay, now from Ermita, let's take a jeepney to España, where the Pontifical and Royal University of Santo Tomas, the Catholic University of the Philippines, is located. UST is the second university in the Philippines to offer the SLP program. Initially, they had offered SLP as a 5-year course, but following the K-12 initiative of our government, they had shortened it into 4 years na lang. Then, since its establishment in 2009, they've already produced 270 graduates, of which 90% of them were immediately employed before or even upon graduation in clinics, therapy centers, schools, community centers, and hospitals. Also, all their students partake in an instructor-led group research and thesis defense under their Center for Health Research and Movement Science, one out of 6 research centers in UST. Lastly, local and international institutions also collaborate with UST to provide their students their internship and community development activities. Then their faculty is composed of 18 members, of which have 30 plus years combined experience in the field of SLP and health education. And also they have 2 sections for first to third year classes, of which they have an average of 40 students per section. So next slide, we have here a quote from Ma'am Judith Damian, the UST SLP program chair. Let me read it to you again. UST's excellence is timely. Its relevance, timeless. This is where students feel at home and experience people, faith, and culture. This is the home of the hashtag Rolling Tigers. Okay, now from España, let's take a UV to Dasma, Cavite, where the La Salle Medical Health Sciences Institute is located. Now, being the youngest to establish SLP as an undergrad program, De La Salle made sure that their program is well-versed with the most updated techniques and professionals' enhancement subjects for their students. And when I say most updated techniques, this is not like a mere marketing catchphrase, because in fact, De La Salle Cavite was recently commended by La Salle Philadelphia for their initiative to develop telepractice as a rotation site for their interns, diba? So talk about advanced mag-isip. And despite being the youngest, DLSM HSI was able to implement diversified programs such as voice lab rotation and Parkinson's rotation with the help of their diverse group of 17 faculty members who are currently pursuing continuing education. So in the next slide, we have here another quote, but this time it's from Ms. Kate Reyes-Brander, the DLSM HSI SLP program director. So to be a student in La Salle is not only to come into a school, but to come into a family. And as she said, De La Salle makes it a point that they are not only after their students' development as a clinician, but also their development of a heart, a soul, the faith, the love, and the love for their service for all the Filipino people. Now set your heart ablaze, and if you want, you can join the Green Archers, hashtag Animo La Salle. And yeah, Okay, lahat pa kayo may passport. Buti na lang at pwede na ang domestic flights. Climb aboard as we virtually head to Mandaue City, Cebu to explore Cebu Doctors University. Now, CDU is strategically located at the center, literally at the center of the Philippines. And because of this, they crown straight access to individuals in the Visayas and Mindanao Islands, or what they call as the Vismin. Thus, they are in charge of creating SLPs who can speak the languages and dialects of the Vismins to eventually address their SLP needs. And their program is specifically developed to address their cutely made core values of SLP. It's to be service-oriented by learning with passion. In addition, what's cool about their program is that the research and career opportunities they offer for their students undergo undergraduate thesis with their mentors as their co-authors, right? How cool, right? And as bright as the various Vismin cultures possesses, CDU ensures a creative and responsive culture with its family, ang kanilang faculty, and its students. So they release monthly departmental updates to the student body containing the difficulties and the wins of their family. Also, regular mental health checkups are conducted, especially for their interns. Then, students are also involved in the decision-making process of the university as monthly, or should I say every 2 months, CDU students through a representative are freely involved in department meetings to express their thoughts. And yeah, Cebu Doctors University is more than its strategic geographic location. This is a place where students become family, build dreams, and seize the world. This is CDU, hashtag primum homo esto. Let him first be a man. And there you have it, the four universities that offer BS SLP as an undergrad. However, I believe education does not stop after undergrad. Graduate programs and certification courses are also available through UP Manila and UST. These are the graduate programs for that we have. It's first we have the Master of Rehabilitation Science, Master of Rehabilitation Science, Speech Pathology, and the Master of Clinical Audiology. On the next slide, we have the certification courses, namely for dysphagia and AAC. O, diba? The program of speech pathology literally has a lot in store for its students. And as they say, no student shall be hindered by finances to pursue his education. That's why all four universities we have mentioned have available internal and external scholarship grants to deserving students. Okay, first with UPM. I would like to emphasize that UP's tuition is free, but there are scholarships and financial assistance available for students via the SLAS through the Office of Student Financial Assistance. Also, a full list of UP Manila scholarships can be accessed via the UP Manila Office of Student Affairs. And then on the next slide, we have the scholarship grants of UST for this academic year. First is the Santo Tomas Academic Scholarships for students with excellent academic performances with the benefits on the next slide. It's the benefits for the Santo Tomas Scholarship. Then on the next slide, we have the other scholarship that USC offers this year. It's the San Martin de Porres Equity Scholarship for students in need of financial assistance with the benefits on the next slide. There. And then, okay, let's now proceed to the scholarships De La Salle Medical Health Sciences Institute provide. So their scholarships may be accessed at their website. It's www.dlshsi.edu.ph under their scholarships page. There you can see their scholarships and tuition fee discounts that may be applicable to you. And lastly, CDU scholarship overview are as follows. So first you have the entrance scholarship. And then on the next slide, they have academic scholarship that comes in full. The next slide for the partials. There. And then next slide. another partial scholarship. And there, by experience, ang pinaka-patok na scholarship with my classmates is the external scholarship from the Department of Science and Technology, Science Education Institute, or what they call as the DOST-SEI. So here in this undergraduate scholarship, SP, Speech Pathology, is a priority course. So here, students can enjoy a monthly stipend and allowance to fund their education needs. Diba, blockmates, or they receive, DOST scholars receive 7,000 monthly allowance, 10,000 book allowance, 1,000 uniform allowance, and 10,000 thesis allowance. Also, if you're studying in a private school, you can also receive 40,000 pesos tuition fee allowance. And yeah, there we have it. The four universities offering speech pathology as an undergraduate course. Whether you be a fighting maroon, a growling tiger, a green archer, or a white stallion, I'm sure you'll be properly equipped to serve the growing needs of Filipinos for professionals like us. Thank you so much for your time. This is Sophia, and have a great day ahead. This is my reference at the next slide. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Sophia. Those were all so cool. I hope all of your visions of the future are now clearer.
Ging, speaking of vision, your vision better be clear in the next and final game. And since this is our last game for today's SPEECHmas, we prepared something very intriguing and exciting. We have lip reading. We will once again divide you into breakout groups. See you later, everyone.
It's colder and the leaves start to fall. Christmas trees on the corner and Santa's at the mall. I don't get excited like everyone else.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. A jingle bell swing and jingle bells ring. Snowing and blowing up bushels of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. A jingle bells chime in jingle bell time. Dancing and prancing in jingle bell square. In the frosty air, what a bright time. It's the right time to rock the night away. Jingle bell time is a swell time to go gliding in a one horse sleigh. Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. A jingle around the clock. Mix and a mingle in the jingling beat. That's the jingle bell. Rock. Jingle bell chime in, jingle bell time. Snowing and blowing our bushels of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bells chime in, jingle bell time. Dancing and prancing in jingle bell square. In the frosty air, what a bright time. It's the right time to rock. Go gliding in a one-horse sleigh. Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. Jingle around the clock. A mix and a mingle and a jingling beat. That's the jingle bell. That's the jingle bell. That's the jingle bell.
at a plus one. Are you free tonight to have some fun? You don't need to bring a present. Yeah, you can just bring yourself and maybe your heart on your sleeve, and we could be married. Mm-hmm. Cancel your plans. It's the celebration of the year. I know it's been a weird one, but let's get together. But I think you're handsome. I've been wanting a condo mansion. Want the love in a hand of phone. So maybe there will be a mistletoe. We could share something under there, you know. Come be my guest to the Christmas party. Let's do this holiday thing right. I choose your company for my side. Laugh at the weird decor. You'll be 5 golden rings and I'll be 4. We leave the house together. Both.
start to think about you. We're really gonna have another Christmas Eve without you. I can't believe it's been so long. Every day finds a way to make me think about you. Like today when we were picking out the tree without you. I can't believe it's been so long. We miss you like hell on the stories that you tell about the boat that you built but never got to sail. I don't know whether I should cry or I should smile through my tears, but if you presents. I even got you one for getting, you're not gonna get it. I can't believe it's been so long. This time around we'll try to smile cause we're sick of tears. Most days are easy now but it gets hard this time of year. But never got to sail. I don't know whether I should cry or I should smile through my tears. But if you that's when we're missing you the most. I don't know whether I should cry or I should smile through my tears, but if you were here we would sail that boat into the red horizon. Those years lost, I tell you all about them. Gone don't always mean that you disappear, cause inside all of us you're still. Inside all of us, you're
Feliz Navidad.
Of our event. Congratulations to our winners. Pero syempre first, we will announce the winner of the second game with a total with 37 points. The second game winner are the wise men. Congratulations. And for the third game, third and final game, if I'm not mistaken, we have a tie, which is Kumuk Cutie Cutie Tops and Lil Drama Squad. Okay, so, sino kaya ang panalo?
Ako na.
With all that, I hope your curiosity about speech pathology was piqued.
Yes. And if there's anything you want to know about today's discussion, now is the time to ask because we will now have our open forum. So just ask. Kahit feeling niyo, ano, super simple lang. Go lang.
Go ahead and send in your questions. Type in your questions.
Para super simple. Send it sa comment, sa chat box. Go lang, guys. Kahit message lang sa co-participants niyo or something, if you want to share something. Before 2 po ba? Don't be shy. It's a free space for everyone. I just want you for my own. More than you could ever know. Make my wish come true. Oh, so may nagtanong. Ano pong favorite subject niyo this sem? Hihi.
Ako bio. Charot.
SP100. Grabe, explain niyo kung ano 'yon.
Okay, so yung ako mag-explain. So yung SP100 is the course na parang nagbibigay ng introduction sa amin sa speech pathology. So within several things na parang nag-interview kami ng SP, nag-ask kami ng mga questions na gustong itanong sa kanya, nag-observe kami ng teletherapy sessions, and then itong event na to. So parang I learned a lot. about sa speech pathology. Tapos parang mas na-inspire ako na, wow. Okay, na-inspire lang ako. Yun lang, share ko lang. Okay, so yung iba ba, meron ba anong favorite subjects daw ng iba? Sabi ni Aina, kung walang SP 100, hindi ko alam saan ako pupulutin. Same. Joke lang daw yung bio, guys, sabi ni Merlin.
Sorry.
Sagot, recorded to.
Recorded to.
Merong nagtanong sa group namin. Lalagay ko na lang rin. Sabihin ko na lang rin yung tinanong sa amin. Go. Ang tanong sa amin, para ano ba, kalimutan ko na. Paolo, ano yung tinanong? Nakalimutan ko. Oh my gosh. Ganun ako kasabaw.
Wait lang. Hindi ko din na naputok, nagbumalik na ako. Sa main room pala.
Ayun, meron daw bang courses na exclusive for SP lang? Ayun.
Parang ang courses.
Ay, subjects.
Majors subjects natin, di ba?
Ah, yung mga majors.
SP100, na. SP126.
Halos SP majors na.
Yes. Uh-oh.
Baka pa-explain naman kung ano yung mga yun.
OGE. So,
ay, talaga ako mag-explain.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Ganun ba yun?
Happy birthday, Jenny. Pa rin
naman. Napabukas ako bigla ng ano, ng canvas. Tama ba yun? Okay, so yung majors namin ay, yun nga, yung SP100, which is yung Introduction to Speech Pathology. So, yun yung course na we're making this project for. Tapos, SP136, Language and Cognitive Functioning. So, I think the course titles says it all naman na. Tapos, SP126, yung Lifespan Development for Speech Pathology. So, basically, lahat naman ng mga sinabi ko, it speaks for itself kung ano yung pag-aaralan. I think yung advantage ng K-12 is sa first years, like sa batch namin ng freshmen, we got to explore agad yung profession. So, first year pala, alam mo na dapat or like parang ipaparamdam na sa'yo kung ano yung profession and kung sure ka na ba sa profession mo. It's the advantage of K-12. So, as early as first sem, first year, makakapag-decide ka na kung SP ba yung para sa'yo. Ganun.
Tsaka to add lang, yung mga major subjects namin, focused siya sa more on sa language development, sa development ng mga tao. And then, meron din siyang medical aspect kasi meron kami iti-take na neuroanat din, I believe. Tapos, ayun, more on sa language, cognitive functioning. Tsaka sa higher subjects, parang meron na silang, hindi ko sure, pero alam ko... Nawala yung isa ko yung sasabihin ko. Ayun, pero yun, more on sa development ng humans, parang sa language na focus doon. Tapos yung may medical aspect din. So, ayun. Ayun. So, for other questions, so... Okay, so we received questions then through the registration form. So first question from the registration form is, okay, is it possible to do self-treatment in dealing with swallowing disorders? Ma'am Pristine, if you're here po.
Ma'am, asalo.
The real speech pathologist. Speech pathologist, Ma'am Pristine.
Go, Ma'am.
Okay. So, hi, everyone. And the question was, if kung kaya ba self-treatment, as in your own, like you're the patient with a swallowing disorder and you will treat it yourself, or... I think that's how I understood the question.
I think that's also the question.
Yes. So I would not really advise you to do self-treatment or to look up for, like, look it up yourself. Ano ba yung how do you treat the swallowing disorder? Because first of all, you don't. Especially if you didn't study like swallowing itself, like how does normal swallowing occur, or ano ba talaga yung maging problema sa swallowing mo, it's going to be difficult for you to really identify how to address the problem then. So it's also something to note then is that if you do have like a swallowing disorder, example, patients who have undergone a stroke, usually minsan they lose the function in their ability to swallow. And the problem is, if you're going to do self-treatment, is that parang it can be dangerous to you, especially if you swallow wrong and instead of the food, instead of going into your stomach, parang pumunta na lang siya sa baga mo. So, I mean, that's very dangerous because it can develop an infection and then you can develop pneumonia or other complications from it. So, I would not advise self-treatment, and you really should visit a professional who is knowledgeable about swallowing in order to get treatment for it.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. And another question is, are there any differences between speech therapists and speech pathologists, or are they just two different terms but serve the same purpose?
Okay, that's like a pretty good question to ask. And from, well, in the Philippines at least, it's more or less the same terms. Parang ginagamit lang interchangeably yung speech therapist or speech pathologist. But if we're going to be quite strict about like the difference between therapist and pathologist, is that a therapist would be someone who just administers like treatment or intervention, versus someone who's like a pathologist, kasi yung word na pathology means to the study of diseases and how they develop. So a speech pathologist is someone then who has the ability to like diagnose people with like speech, language, communication, or swallowing disorders. So if you're going to be very strict about the term to use, that's the difference between therapist or pathologist. But in the Philippines, interchangeable naman sila.
Okay.
Okay, for the next question, what do future speech language pathologists need to keep in mind when treating a patient, both morally and medically speaking?
Wow. Well, that's a very good question as well, especially I think if you're very interested in this field. So what do you have to keep in mind? Well, medically, you would have to keep in mind all of the things that you learn about speech pathology, like what is the normal development of like language of speech, or the normal functioning of swallowing. And those kinds of knowledge will sure help you as you try to assess your clients or as you try to give therapy to them. So medically, probably should remember that. And for the morally part, or well, as I've explained before, then ethics and morals are actually quite different from each other. So well, so maybe in terms of the ethics part, I mean, you have to keep in mind that speech pathologists adhere to an ethical code. This code is just a guideline of what it's expected of us, how we're supposed to act professionally, and how do we sort of guide us in also making our decisions so that it's in the best interest of the client, of our profession, and for like everyone in society. So so yeah, you would have to keep in mind yung mga ethical principles, things like do no harm, or remembering like the autonomy of the patient, that they can make decisions about their how they want therapy or intervention to go, especially if making sure that they're informed about all their options and what's the benefits and the risks of those options. So I hope that answers that question.
Okay, for our last question for this open forum, what do futures... Oh, sorry. How can speech pathology affect us in our everyday life or in our society? How can this help us?
Will I still answer this? Or does someone in the class want to answer that? Thank you. How can this help us? Well, it's always good to be aware, I think, to have an awareness of what speech pathology is. As mentioned sa talk a while ago, there's like a lot of misconceptions about what speech pathology actually is. And those misconceptions can hurt us because they prevent us from maybe getting the appropriate help we need, especially if you know, if you're someone with like a communication or swallowing disorder. Or it can also not, it wouldn't be good also because then maybe you know someone who has a communication or swallowing disorder, and then like because of your misconceptions, you're not able to help them. So awareness is good because we do away with those misconceptions, and this is relevant, I think, in for everyone, because communication, as mentioned, communication, the ability to eat and swallow, those are all very vital things that we do every day. Now, we don't even think about it. It comes so natural or easy to us. But everyone, but there are some people who do have difficulties with it, and they also deserve the opportunity to be able to communicate with, communicate what they have, what their thoughts and their ideas. And they also deserve to be able to have a good quality of life. And that means also being able to nourish their bodies through eating. So, I think that's that would summarize why it's relevant to all of us in society.
Thank you, Paul. So, I hope that was enlightening for all of you. We are now nearing the end of this event, but first, let's have our final raffle. For this, I would like to call on Angel and Louie.
Hello, guys.
Hi,
guys. Welcome back to us, Louie. So, wait, nawala yung script ko. Joke lang. Okay, welcome back to us, Louie. So, guys, did you have fun? Thumbs up if yes. Tapos if no, pwede na kayong mag-leave ng meeting. Joke lang.
Harsh mo naman, Angel. But seriously, guys, we hope that you had fun because we had fun too. Now for our most exciting part, our announcement of winners! Woo! Yay!
Guys, so guys, who do you think won and why is it Kumo Cutie Cutie Taps?
Excuse me, Angel. It's May Bingkas. Diba, guys?
Ano ba? Group 5 yung nanalo. Huwag kayong ano.
Wait lang, wait lang. Mamaya.
Okay, so legit na to. Ito na talaga. Para, our winning team is Louie. What, who is the winning team? Alam mo ba? Alam mo na ba kung ang sinong team nalo?
Hindi ko pa actually alam sino yung nanalo.
So, ang nanalo is the scoreboard na to with a total of 110 points.
Grabe naman yan.
110 points, grabe. Alam niyo ba yung difference ng first, second place? 2 points. 2 points lang. At itong group na may 110 points ay ang Lil Drama Squad.
Yay!
Congratulations, Lil Drama Squad.
Appreciated by Bingel and Shane. Hi, guys. Congrats.
Yung facilitators, meron ba kayong gustong i-share?
Oo nga. Baka meron kayong ano, mga
pinaya.
Ano, actually, shy type yung group ko. Oh, as in, ang lala. Nag-react lang sila. Pero, ayun, nanalo pala sila. So, congrats sa kanila kahit react-react lang sila dyan. Si Psyche na pa competitive, guys. Nakakatakot. Yun lang. Natakot yung mga participant.
Psyche, do you have something to say?
Pressure ata sila sa akin. Yun na, pero at least, diba, nag-enjoy naman sila later on. Kailangan na mag-warm up.
Wow.
Napa 100 bigla yung score. Thank you!
Yay! Palakpakan!
Grabe. Alam niyo ba yung first point nila sa first round? 7. No. 7. Ah. Yung naging 110. Ano kaya?
Oo, yun yung ano, nag-react sila sa round sa first game. React-react lang sila. Tapos na sa third game, naka-on-cam na sila.
Saang point, saang game kayo nakahabol?
Sa third ata.
Competitive.
Kailangan lang na little push.
Yeah.
Saan mo sila tinulak sa hiki?
Okay guys, gusto nyo bang malaman kung ano, yung mga prizes na pwede nyo mapanalunan as the winning team? Tama ba, Angel? Tatlo yung mapubunot sa kanila?
Yes! Ilan ba kayo? 5? Oh, ayos lang. Oh.
Three of you have the chance to win first, Annabelle face mask. And then, yung second na mabubunot, pwede siyang manalo ng Derek Shepherd Grey's Anatomy Canvas Tote Bag with Zipper and Grey's Anatomy Sticker Pack. 5 pieces. And then, yung last na mabubunot, meron siyang oval trinket dish and dalawang circle coaster. Ayan yung mga pwede niyong mapanalunan.
Yes! Grabe! Ang gaganda naman ng prizes. Parang gusto ko sinigit
ko sa yes! I know, right? The question is, paano natin malalaman kung sino yung mananalo?
Dui!
Yung kanilang 5.
Tinatanong pa ba yan? Pag ako? Siyempre, ang gagamitin natin dyan. Of course. Ay, wait lang. Screenshot. Ay, wait lang daw. Pag nag-screenshot daw ako, mawawala yung sound. Okay. Kakantahan ko na, kakantahan na lang kayo ni Louie.
Oh my gosh.
Okay. So, paano natin nalaman kung sino yung tatlong winners ng ating raffle for today? Simple! The magical Wheel of Names.
Yes, favorite ko yan. Lagi ako na ano dyan
eh. May kulang ata dito.
Unfair yan. Unfair. Ano bang team mo?
Lil Drama Squad. Siyempre, Lil Drama Squad.
Parang hindi naman kanina. Parang iba yung pinaglalaban mo kanina.
Okay.
So, okay, let's start.
Nagsushuffle ako. Proof lang na wala akong, walang daya to.
Oh, tama. Two-timer si Angel.
Ng ating Annabelle face mask ay malalaman sa aking pagbabalik.
Ay, ano yan?
Ang nanalo! Ang mananalo! Woo! Guys!
Hey guys, go guys!
Tapos yung pagbato nyo! Danica!
Yay! Hey, ang galing! Danica!
Ay, siya yung nanalo na ano, diba?
You won 3 pieces of Annabelle face mask.
Ano yan?
Siya yung nanalo ng EXO SC album.
Ikaw ba?
Ay! Suki ka pala! Suki ka pala!
Bakit galit si Ria?
Parang bakit pihalong galit yun, Ria?
Talagang tinagalang galit, guys.
Sumali kasi ako doon, tapos hindi ako nanalo.
Okay lang yan, Ria.
Sorry, Ria.
Anika, kay Ria, ha? Parang may kinanakit siya sa'yo, eh.
Tama, favorite ni Lord, si Danica.
Okay.
So, i-copyin ko na lang yung shipping details na nilagay mo dito sa...
Bakit parang... Ang kukopyin ko na lang ulit.
Abahan ka na, Danica. Pupuntahan ka ni Ria.
Tama. Kukunin niya yung ano.
I'm not like that.
Okay.
So, okay.
Next winner.
Next winner. Spin that wheel.
And wait lang, anong price na itong second winner natin?
Yun yung mga Grey's Anatomy.
So, fan shop.
Hey, Diana! Hi, Diana!
Diana, congratulations!
Congratulations! You
thank
won
you,
the
thank you po.
Grey's Anatomy canvas tote bag with zipper and Grey's Anatomy sticker pack.
So, fan shop ba yan, guys?
First time mo lang
yes, Ria, ako. Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Parang wala pa siyang hinanakit na ikaw ulit yung
hinanakit. Well deserved. No, well deserved.
First time niya manalagay.
Okay. So, okay pa yun kay Ria.
Okay, last one.
Wait, Gusto ko lagyan ng twist. Lagay natin si Ria dito. Ria!
Wag na babawasan yung ano nila, yung probability.
Wag, pag ako talaga hindi pa ako nanalo dyan, iiyak na lang ako.
Mananalo na ba si Ria? Shuffle. Pero pag nanalo si Ria, iiyak na lang.
Okay. Nanalo ako, pipigilin na lang ako sa tatatlo.
Nanalo, i-exit ko
na lang.
At ang nanalo.
Pag-alala ko ulit. For the final
prize. Ay, si...
Final prize is...
Ria!
Ria!
Okay lang yan. Katabi ka na, oh.
Mark Lauren!
Salamat!
Yay, congrats, Mark Lauren! Nanalo ka ng oval trinket dish and isang circle coaster. Congrats, Mark Lauren.
Congratulations to all our winners.
Yes, so, congrats, people.
Okay, so para... Ay, sige. Sorry.
Nope.
Okay, so sa mga raffle winners, I'll just message you to ask you for your details. And, ayan. So, I'll directly message you kung isi-ship na or something yung products niya. So, and thank you. So, hintayin niyo na lang yung message ko mamaya o kaya bukas. So, ayun. Thank you din sa sponsors natin. So, don't forget to thank them din. Okay, so, thank you.
Ingat na lang po si ano, kay Ria.
Thank you, Ria.
Baka hindi ma-ship. Anako, sorry, hindi po na-ship. Nawala yung ano, nagka-problem. Ria, ha? Kilala ka namin. Okay, so thank you. Now that nabigay na ang prizes,
yes.
Nakapag-enjoy, pwede na tayo mag-proceed sa ating closing remarks.
Let's go.
Mag-ano? Ako pa mag-ano? Kayo pa ba mag-ano?
Hello, so congrats to our winners. To top off this program, we will be having our closing remarks, like Angel said.
So we're gonna call someone again, someone very wonderful for the closing remarks. Here with us today is Ma'am Christine Chua. After graduating with a degree in BS Speech Pathology from UB Manila, she currently works as an instructor at our very own UB Manila College of Allied Medical Professions, as well as a pediatric speech pathologist. She has also contributed to the field through her research and is a member of the Philippine Association of Speech Pathologists. Let's all welcome Ms. Christine Chua.
Hey, so good evening, everyone. And what can I say except that today was truly a very merry way to end the 12 days of SPEECHmas. So through all the informative social media posts, insightful lectures, and fun activities, I'm sure that all of us have learned so much and have gained a greater awareness and appreciation of speech pathology. So it's this knowledge of the profession that we can use as a gift that to bless others, as I mentioned, whether it's through sharing to them about their the need for speech pathology in their lives, or even like sharing to your friends or your loved ones, and maybe that's how they end up becoming a speech pathologist. And so I would like to take the time to thank all of the people who made this event possible. So first of all, I'd like to thank the UP Manila BS Speech Pathology Batch 2024, who have worked tirelessly to make this event 12 Days of SPEECHmas and the SpeechPath PH project, the success that it is. So I'd also like to thank our guest speakers for today for having shared with us very inspiring messages and enlightening us about the value of the SP profession. So thank you to Vice President Lenny Robredo, Sir Fernando Ligot, and Ma'am Susie Pascual. And then I'd also like to thank our event partners and sponsors. So the Philippine Association of Speech Pathologists, the UP Collegiate Association of Speech Pathologists, and the UP Health Sciences and Pre-Medicine Society, UP CAMP Association of Physical Therapy Students, the Society of Occupational Therapy Majors, CDU Speech Pathology Ushers of Resolve, and then to our sponsors, yung Arium, Shop PH, Blank Slate, Kaka Kombucha, Succeed, Fan Shack, Mooncake, Moonlight, and the UP Sigma Alpha Nu Sorority, Manila. So thank you for your unwavering support for the Speech Path PH. And last and most definitely not the least, thank you to our dear participants for spending your Saturday afternoon and evening with us, for participating in the games, asking questions, and continuously engaging with the social media posts of the Speech Path PH. So we hope that you enjoyed the event and that this has indeed sparked an interest in you, like, for this field of speech pathology. So Merry Christmas, everyone, and hopefully we will see you in the profession very soon.
Thank you for your wonderful message, Ma'am Pristine. Before we end this event, may we ask all of you to open your cameras so we can have a commemorative picture for this SPEECHmas.
Ako na.
Ako rin, mag-take rin ako.
Okay.
Smile.
Page 2. Okay na.
Okay? Okay na ba yung picture?
Yeah.
Okay. And on that note, we have officially reached the end of this event. I'm sure that the knowledge and moments that you receive today will be kept as memories in your heart as you journey on the path to speech pathology. Certificates of participation for this event will be given after you answer the feedback form that will be posted on Facebook.
We had so much fun today. I hope you guys did too. Thank you for joining us for SPEECHmas.
Bye, everyone.
Bye-bye. Thank you.
Next time. Ayaw pa ba guys? No. No. Ay, 35 na lang. Sakto. Wow. Ay, joke lang. Check.
May umalis ata na blockmate.
May hindi ata na
may umalis.
I think. Not sure.
End record na tayo.
Parang ba?
End ko na.
Yay!
Yay! Yay!